this seems to be good enough for me. Now to create the back portion, what I'll do is I'll carefully select this shape, the base rectangular shape, and I'll copy and paste this. So I'll make a copy by pressing Ctrl C, and again I'll press Ctrl V. Push it downwards like this. All right, and we'll let it be like this. So for the back portion, I will be putting up the real information, like the, for the person, we are creating the visiting card, designation of the person, their address or something like that. But before that, let's come to the designing of the visiting card. So like in, on the front, I have created this wavy sort of design, and I have put the radial gradient for the color part, so that I am keeping the same, but I will try to see if I can, you know, we can make some changes in this sort of design, or maybe to create something new. So for this also, I will be starting with a rectangular shape and keeping it aligned edge to edge, and I'll not the radial but color fill, I'll choose a flat color. Maybe we can pick up this stone, so I'll click and we can click on this. So this will, you know, keep it uniform. Alright. Now again, I want to deform this shape as well. So I'll right click and I'll choose convert to path. Now obviously, next thing is I need to choose subselect so that I can get the control of nodes. And what I'll do, I'll select this node and I'll put this one over here. So I'm not inserting a new one, I'm just using the node which I already have, and I'm just, you know, changing its position. And again for this also, I'll keep mirrored, and let's see what kind of shape I can get. This much, okay, this is done. Now after this, what I'll do is I'll make a copy of this shape, so Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and I'll bring it a bit upwards like this, and I'll change its color a bit darker gray tone, somewhat like this. Now next, what I want is I want this shape behind this black one. Okay, so that is quite simple. We can select the shape and we can come to this toolbar, and then we can choose bring element backward, and it will send it back. So either you can click from here, I can see that, you know, this shape is behind this black shape, or else you can right click on the shape, you can go to the arrange, and from here also you can choose the same. You can see one more option, send to back. Send to back means it will send it to the backward option, just like so, the backward position, meaning that this shape will go behind this rectangle as well. So that we don't want. So backward means it will take it step by step, one shape at a time. It will take it back of one shape at a time. So that seems good enough. So I'll select this, and immediately after one option, I have got the desired result. I wanted it behind this one only, so this seems about right. Now I will make some more changes into this. I'll slightly bring it a little bit down like this, and now I will rotate this shape. Okay, so for rotate, you can select and you can come to the inspector panel, and you can, you know, just drag with the mouse like this to rotate, or else you can bring with the pointer tool, you can select the shape, and at the corner points, make sure not the center one but the corner one, if I'll bring cursor closer to the node. Okay, make sure not overlap. If you overlap, this will give you the control to resize the shape. That we won't want, that we don't want. We actually want to rotate. So the rotate controller comes when I'll just, you know, hover the cursor around the node. So from here also, you can click and you can rotate the shape. So whichever way you find it easier, you can do so. Otherwise, you can do from here as well. So, but just to show you, you know, the common method to rotate the shape, I am using this method with the pointer tool, and I'll rotate it around like this, and then I'll push it downwards like this. Maybe around like this. Let's rotate it. This seems about right. No need to worry if it is going out. That's the next step where we will be fixing it. So zoom in a bit more and pointer tool, select the shape, edge to edge, align this pointer. And as for these ones, I will change this to sub select, and I'll just simply select this node and I'll push it inwards like this. Similarly, I'll go over here on this side and I'll choose the sub select, and I'll select this node and I'll push it upward like this. Okay, now let's zoom out and see how the design is looking. So this seems about right. I wanted it to look like that, so this could come. Now I'll select these two shapes. So once these two shapes are selected, make sure that you know it is not going way too much if you want to keep this sort of design. So I want to squeeze a bit, because here we need to put a lot of information, so I want a bit more space. So still it is looking fine. Now after that, I'll select both the shapes. And I'll copy and paste Control C and Control V, and then I'll push it upwards. And now from the toolbar, I will be flipping this first horizontally and then vertically. And then carefully I'll align it edge to edge like this. So now the back of the visiting card, the design, base design of the back of the visiting card is done. Now all I need to do is I need to put the information here. Now for the information, first thing what I want to do is, still on the back side, I want to highlight the brand for which I am creating this. So on the left portion, I will be putting the logo and with the company name or the brand name, and on the right side I will keep all the information. So for that, I will be simply copying the logo and the brand name from here, Control C and V, and let's bring it out here, and we will scale it a bit down. And let it be like this. Okay, we'll see if we need to rescale it up. So we can do it afterwards, but for the time being, let it be like this. And after that, I'll choose text tool over here and I'll click and I will write name. So first thing I want to highlight over here, the name. So maybe I can write my name. Alright, size seems to be way too big for this, so I'll reduce it from 20, let's say around 40. Seems about right as of now. Copy and paste this text, and this text I have made copy where I want to highlight the designation or the job profile. So what I'll do, double click on this and I will write my job position. Okay, actually, so I will write graphic designer, and for this size I need to reduce, let's say around 6 or so, seems about right, and I'll align on the right side with the name. Now, once this done, I will be adding more information such as like email ID, phone number, address, any website if there is. So what I'll do, I will make copy of these texts, Control C and Control V, bring it downwards, and I'll make 2-3 copies. Now let's quickly change this text. So at the first, what I want to display is email ID. So for email ID, just double click on this, and I'm just, you know, writing dummy information over here, because, you know, writing the real one is not mandatory. So let's say xyz@gmail.com. This we can say. 1 second. gmail.com. Like this. Okay, this is email ID. Then this one I want to consider as address. So for address also, let's say, just for the dummy information, okay, even when you are also creating for the, just for the design purposes, you do not need to put the real informations here as well. But just so the design should look more very relevant and relatable, then I am just putting the information which is sort of real. So for the address, I will write down, let's say, India. 10, a pin code 10, somewhat like this. This is my address. Then I'll come here, and here I want to write down the website if I have any. So I will be using the brand name with that. covendesigns.com. So just I have created this sort of dummy name. The last one, I want to display the mobile number or any contact number. So I'll double click here, and I'll give a dummy number over here, let's say 9810 and 0001. Make sure these are 10 number digits.